kick slider or top rope hurricane run on Mako Sagamore. So they trade strikes. Perez eats another big kick from Mako.
Here we go.
Sodomore delivers
down the bar, the Young Bucks, Indianapolis tag team titles. In this bitch, you know, you know.
This time to the much more experienced Mako Sagamore. And Jade runs in it, match Jade blindsides Perez by hitting her across the back with a shot from the kendo stick. Sagamore comes back to the ring to run off Jade, and that was it.
Damn!
Jade is still feuding with Roxanne, and I would assume Roxanne's gonna get the one up on Jade whenever that second match happens, because they really made Roxanne look like a living fool in that match against Jade, poor Jade, or since Jade Cargill, poor Jade, here on NXT. We got the Dyad! Dyad, or the Schism, whatever the fuck they call them, Joe Gacy announced. They were in the back. They were talking about, what the fuck they were talking about. They were
looking
over
the rules. Oh, we're not down slash hammer.
Tiana James walked by with her obvious new assistant.
Knuckleball.
Tiana James' new assistant.
Bella.
Somebody please go find Tiana James' new assistant's name. I'm very curious to know.
Bella. Shut up.
I think that is going to be me asking for more TV time. Whatever she is, man, we got to get her back.
You just got all of
her. Some coach said, she doesn't free sponsorship. She told her assistant to trash the smiley face button. She got on the phone and berated somebody about dunking.
Bella. Not the one, but tag team titles at the Hell in a Cell pay-per-view. And oh, shit.
Joe, Mario breaks. And her schedule was too full to another assistant as James approached about Joey Stark and the Lions. Well, looks like we're getting a tag team match with Deanna James and Ari Express and Joey Stark and the Lions. Great! I can't wait. Listen, Scott, there's no. You guys love it. I think you have to be a 50-50 fair. Deanna James, I'm enjoying the game. She plays it very well. The more I see it, the more I think, I really like her. And she's not that bad, right? She reminds me a lot of Tiffany Stratton. The Tiffany Stratton, first of all, her outfit was good. Had the tape she had. And she's very physical in the ring. She's not afraid to get in there, actually. From what I've seen. I'm definitely going to keep an eye on her, because
that's the ball!
And then she's going to be there. And I'm going to get it. And I don't see it. You're shaking. One-on-one with Trick Williams. This is a singles match. This didn't really do much for me. I'm not a big Trick Williams guy.
Watch it, America! Oh, Bella!
Learning the fact that Ricochet and Carmelo Hayes.
We are how on each other here. Which one's the tag team titles is all about here? One of those tag team titles in that tables action chairs match. The triple threat TLC match. And the Bucks is in that match. One of those titles. Oh shit, I'm done. It's Moxie and Rollins. Russian leg sweep by Nick Jackson. Went on and on, Austin. Page, I'm done. This Sunday, the Royal Rumble. Another one! Oh, Trish Stratus defending the Rumble's title. Oh, Brian Buster! And then straight up goes out this Sunday night. And a twist of fate! And Dick Jackson! And a twist of fate ballad! And a flip power driver! And Cornelia Destroyer!
Trick Williams did interfere in that match, and he did cost Ricochet a couple of points
in
that match.
Go ahead, Trick
Williams here with a shooting star press. Not really much for this. Very predictable. Carmelo hit with that ringside.
Go on, bitch.
Ricochet is in there. Williams is mocking him.
Michaels, Benoit, Guerrero, triple threat for the WWE title. Sting, Goldberg, Brett, Austin, in a four-way match. The Malaysian Kanga versus the Samoan Submission Machine, Samoa Joe. And your boy, the Malaysian Kanga, for the world title this Sunday night. It's going to be a huge night in Madison Square Garden this Sunday night at the Royal Rumble.
We've got a very good video package.
You know damn well The Undertaker won payback with Diamond Dallas Page and WCW. Those bitches jumping The Undertaker last week in the damn parking lot. And Balor, and oh my God. You know damn well they're not going to show up here tonight. WCW, they better not. Who knows what happens. Do you want to count? The thing is, some WCW... Oh my God! Oh no! Submission! Jackson! No!
There may have been just as many people talking about you than there was watching an impact.
Shester!
Nobody was talking about Damon Kent.
Give
me a call. Shortest introduction to Damon Kent. Strong introduction to the group. He said the three brothers became dominant, but he got no thanks. He said Strong never put him in the singles ranks, and Strong called him to be in Asia. He said Brutus doesn't like him because he put Brutus' ass in college, and Julius is jealous of him because Strong likes him. He said two more hours when he put two outfits together, but it was hard to keep a straight face.
Just got bleeding! He said,
Papa! He had one last chance, but he shot them down at noon with half of the gun. He said the sound of the steel chair hitting Julius' back
stood
at the end of God in mind. He said it's not Diamond Mine forever, it's Damon Kent. Good stuff. I like that they gave us some backstory. I like that they...
Oh, no, holy shit!
Who he is. He was part of Diamond Mine. And
what?
He went over exactly why he did what he did. He developed feelings, you know, working alongside these guys. And he didn't forget about Julius being jealous because Roddy likes him better over Julius. And Brutus doesn't like him because he whooped Brutus's ass in college. Good stuff. It's good stuff. I mean, I don't necessarily care about it, but I appreciate the dad tracking explaining to me why he did what he did. Great. Now what happens with Roddy? I don't know. What happens with the three brothers? Do they go and kind of get some like narrative change? Or are they going to remain more of the same? I don't know. It'll be interesting. So we move on. Henry Grimes is walking in the back.
Damn it, another one!
By Tony D'Angelo and Stacks. Drinking espresso. Stacks ready an espresso for Grimes. Grimes says he doesn't know Italian, so he's going to say this very slowly. The answer is no. He doesn't want to join. D'Angelo said the other two guys that say no aren't here anymore.
Another one!
Grimes says he's not like them. Lorenzo said it's because people actually respected them. Grimes then threw the espresso at Stacks, and D'Angelo gave him the urinary through the tank. It looks like we're getting, like I said before, it looks like we're getting back to Tony D'Angelo. Looks like we're getting Tony D'Angelo versus Kevin Grimes. There you go. Mackenzie Mitchell. She was back with Diamond Mine as Brutus interrupted and said he wants to break Damon Kemp's face. Said Damon Kemp is caught in the studio discussing the match that happened 5 or 6 years ago.
No, Papa!
He definitely broke them and said they can beat them on Sunday, but the people don't believe it, so they're going to change that. He said the WWE Universe can put the stipulation for that title match against Diamond Mine. Julius Reed said everything that's happened, all the rage he's been building inside, he's going to take it out on their bitch asses next week. Pretty deadly, didn't like being called bitch asses. Nathan Frazier versus Axiom.
Dude, what is that? The one!
Great! Great. I mean, what's the score? What is the winner get? I don't know. But these two, I mean, it was a good match. I just don't find any reason to care. I don't. I hate the Frazier's great. Don't get me wrong, he's great. There's no reason for me to care about any of these guys. They really aren't positioned as important guys. They just exist. They just there. So Axiom wins a very fast-paced match here. And the pace pretty much kept up that same pace at most of the match. So they got a commercial break.
Just that counter!
And they slowed the pace down just a little bit. And he's working on the arm of Frazier. Frazier rolls to his feet. Hits him back, elbows Axiom.
Holy shit! Down on a 1916!
Across his shoulder, the momentum kind of switches to his side. Frazier was sent out by the announcers.
Axiom was complying
with Tope. Rolled Frazier back into the ring. Hit a high cross body for a two count. Hit a lock down to moralized. And he didn't have the leverage.
Another one!
And Axiom held on as he sat on Frazier. Hooked his legs around Frazier's body for more leverage. But Frazier turned it into a vertical spinning neck break. But Frazier's on
another offense,
he hits a combo.
Offense
here, moonsault, deep kick in the second rope. Axiom tried to quick inside right before the knee, but Frazier kicked the knee.
You son of a bad one!
He went for a standing shooting star, but Axiom put the knees up. Walked out a triangle armbar. He transitioned into a rings of Saturn, but Frazier
is so bad.
Axiom just stomped on his back. Frazier rolled through some kicks, holding on to
knock
his legs for a bumpy grab. Frazier went into a single leg grab and then a high elevated knee lock.
Axiom
grabbed the rope
for a bump.
Axiom had quit Superman 4
for two counts
and then hit his leaping super kick for a three over at Nathan Frazier. He takes the 1-0 advantage in the best of three series. I wonder if it's
knock a ball.
I'm sure we're going to get three matches after this match, because that's the way these...
What a mad holy
moly! Good match, very difficult to care about the ending. No matter how good the ending match is.
Nakamura! Oh my god!
Security in the back. Williams.
Run to the table! Run to the ladder! Oh my god!
Javier Bernal.
Oh my god!
Williams yelled at him to go away. Williams says he may just be security, but
back
in the day of the week, you prick.
Opening
the door for their entrance, so Williams had to go off with security. And, I believe this is William Regal's son, if I'm not mistaken. I believe this may be William
Regal's son. Just God,
I'm gone! They're giving this no bullshit at all. Really good stuff. Gallus made their way to the ring at that time for me. We got the Super Diva. The Super Diva. Quincy Elliott. He was on a bedazzled moped. A bedazzled moped. He was riding through town waving at
me. Oh!
He said nothing is cuter than a boy in his scooter, and he's bringing all of it to NXT. Quincy Elliott is debuting now. Be ready with my remote control in hand to readily change the channel. Okay. Garbage. We got Braun Breaker. Braun Breaker and Tyler Bate versus Gallus. This was the main event of NXT tonight. Decent little tag team match here that was obviously a setup for JD McDonough.
A match.
Get a nice cheap shot. Vanity face because he's going to be involved in the world title.
Oh my god, I'm not going to tell!
We got these four guys here. Good tag
team. Damn!
Joe and Breaker began the match. Joe Coffey began taunting Breaker. He responded with a big shoulder tackle. I like the makeup of these guys. Gallus has always been good. They make a nice matchup for Braun Breaker. So I like the back and forth between Breaker and Gallus. So the heels, you know, they turn the tide after a break. They are gaining an advantage on Tyler Bate, obviously beating him down, getting some heat on the baby face before they make a hot tag for Breaker. Gallus goes to isolate Bate, Bate doing the same thing. Bate eventually creates some separations, gets the hot tag. Breaker mows down Gallus and calls him around with suplexes. Breaker pulls down his straps, signaling for the finish. Breaker tags Bate. They execute a sloppy-looking doomsday device, tribute to the Steiner Brothers. Bate leaps off the top of the climb bulldog. It was only a near fall. Breaker with an assist.
Look at that! Oh my god! Matt Jackson!
And the team of Braun Breaker and Tyler B gets the victory. And that was basically it. Andre Paul. Tyler Driver 97. Andre Paul. After the match, McDonough attacked both Menson and Breaker outside and in Devlin's side to bait.
What a match!
The crowd and Baker reacted to the ring. They were both pointing at him. That's the way the show went. You know, like I said, it's not a bad show. I just don't think the stories are captivating enough. I don't think they're engaging enough. They don't really, they make it very difficult for me to invest my time in what they're telling. Storyline.
Tombstone!
That show is just—it's just a byproduct of the Vince McMahon Bruce Pritchard era. It really is.
What happened to one, two, three,
and a half? It's still the same fucking look, the same show that we remember, and they're celebrating a one-year anniversary next year. As if this is a good thing. They're celebrating a one-year NXT 2.0 anniversary next year. Next week, but like this is something for fucking celebrating. Nobody wants to celebrate a one-year anniversary of NXT 2.0. No! They are not going to get this brand back to where it needs to be.
What a match and another one!
It continues doing the same thing that we saw in the last administration. They need to change it. They need to change music and theme and colors and fucking whatever. You know, it's not going to be where it needs to be unless those subtle changes need to be made. Okay? Not a bad show, it's just fucking boring. It's so vanilla.
My God!
It's something it's not. And it's not coming off right. Thank you guys very much for all of your support, man. We are going to hit the super chats, and then I am going to make myself
my drink. God.
And put some guesty for the rest of the evening.
And another one!
Can I hit that thumbs up? I see 596 likes. I need 1,000 minutes. I don't know what the fuck you guys are doing. But I'm not entertaining you tonight that I can't get 1,000 likes. Was it half of you fall asleep like I did then?
Damn!
Get those super chats in. Get those memberships in. Hit that subscribe button down below. Turn on the bell for notifications. Let me... We were 4 subs away from 137 likes. Didn't get it. 137,000. Thank you guys very much. You guys are welcome. Continue to hit that subscribe button. Follow me on social media at JDFMNY206, Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, and download. Tonight's show is sponsored by my great friends over at Blue Chew. BlueChew.com, code JD at checkout for your free sample. Guys, the summer's over, but that doesn't mean the summer's got to be over in the bedroom. Confidence can take you far in life, fellas. And that's where Blue Chew comes into play. Blue Chew is a unique online service that delivers the same active ingredients as Viagra and...
Look, come on, not a kill, son of a bitch! It grabs it! Oh, boy!
You can take them anytime, day or night. You can plan ahead or be ready whenever the opportunity arrives. And the process is very simple, man. BlueChew.com is where you sign up. You consult with one of their online medical providers. And once you are approved, you'll receive your prescription within days. The best part is, it's all done online. No doctor's office, no awkward conversations, no
waiting in
line for pharmacy. And Blue Chew's tablets are made in the USA and are prepared and shipped direct to you in a very discreet package. We have to talk about first impressions, guys. What about life? Let's take Braun Strowman, for example, guys. Braun Strowman made his return on Monday Night Raw. That was his first impressions back in the WWE. And it wasn't a good one. You don't want to be Braun Strowman. You do not. So make sure you guys create a great first impression and a great lasting impression. We Blue Chew. Special deal for everybody, man. BlueChew.com, code JD at checkout for your free sample. That is a great deal to me. BlueChew.com, code JD. I want to thank my friends over at Blue Chew for sponsoring today's NXT Post Show. Right here on Off the Script. Let's get into the super chats, guys. I know I missed a few from the earlier stream this afternoon. So let's pick it up with a couple of those that I missed. Hal L was a $2 super chat. CM Punk is acting so stupid. Yeah. Mustangs rule. Thank you, Hal. Miles Marable with a $4.99 super chat. JD, have you thought about using gifts of your impersonations as super chats? Like an almost super chat with Kevin Dunn, Charlotte Flair, Braun Strowman, etc. No. I do not do that, Miles. I think that's low budget. I'm all about high quality. That is not going to end with a high quality. Sorry to disappoint you if you expect me that much. Joseph Taylor, $2 super chat. CK will always choose the up over CM Punk. Tony Khan needs to choose to be a boss.
Oh my God!
Anybody in the world. There's a time for business and there's a time for celebration. MGM Bolin! $4.99 super chat. Don't even watch or care about NXT. Just need to listen to my tribal chief talk so I can get my mind off usual BS. I can't thank you enough, James. Connie
bleeding.
How many of you guys have been watching NXT that are in the same boat as MGM Bolin? Do you watch NXT or not? Or you just come here and listen to me rant about it? Either way, I appreciate it. I got the best name for it. Jordan Blades with a $5 super chat. JD, did you happen to see the big off the script sign on NXT Worlds Collide? Yes, I did. That was my boy Kevin. It's very visible at the beginning of the show if you want to check it out. Yes, I wonder if the sign was taken away. Because I didn't see it anymore throughout the entire show. Or maybe he just didn't want to raise the sign and wanted to get his point across right at the beginning. Or maybe he thought the show was so fucking terrible that he didn't want to.
Drive!
But having it seen on the shitty show.
So broke down!
Baby in Cleveland with a $5 super chat. I was working for the
Cleveland
earlier stream. Hell of a show, man. Thank you, JD and Jesse, for making my work day great. OTS is number
one. What a band!
I appreciate it.
One! Canada!
Logical tape of what is going on with all of the CM Punk's work. Johnny Fisterbottom.
Low blow!
But I wouldn't have him drop it to MJF or maybe Wardlow because MJF needs to stay here. Then continue the MJF Wardlow feud. I don't know what they do, Johnny. It's going to be very difficult keeping MJF as a heel. It's going to be very, very difficult. Dennis H with a $50 super chat. Dennis H, that was in my boat. Tony Khan probably just forgot to change CM Punk's diaper before the post show scrum. Yes, everybody was wrong there, man. Everybody was told Tony Khan was wrong, CM Punk was wrong, he was wrong. Nobody is getting away from this without me. Nobody. Joseph Taylor, $5 super chat. Happy to be trained by Bianca Belair and still be awkward in the ring like Flash Legend. Is she really trained by Bianca? Please, bro, don't tell me that's true. Please, do not tell me that Bianca Belair has trained Flash Legend. Please. Kyle Billings with a $5 super chat. Do you think USA would ever let NXT go to Peacock at 1 hour? Or is it like Raw at 3 hours?
Oh, super good!
Thank you for 137,000 subscribers.
The growth this year has been tremendous, man. Absolutely fucking over the moon about the support the podcast is being given. Follow me on social media at JDPNY206. That's Twitter, Instagram, TikTok, and Cameo. Continue to hit that thumbs up. Make sure you guys go check out the stream from earlier. If you guys want all of the latest up-to-date info on Slam Dunk and the storyline there.
Oh my God!
Jesse and I will see you tomorrow night. Make it big night for AEW. So
match.
I need two things for me. Number one, I need those guitar emojis in the chat. VIPs, I need that mustache emojis in the chat. And number two, I need that music on max. Guys, I'll see you tomorrow night. Big night for AEW in the venue. Dynamite, post show, off the script. Live. And I'll see you tomorrow night, guys. Have a good one.
My God!
When you've been on the road for almost 10 years straight, and someone who has been at the highest level, the main event level, I ran a full schedule for a long time. Even before we went to Fox, it changed to where it was SmackDown on Friday, then we did two live events Saturday, Sunday, then there was the annual Monday Night Raw. So that's a four-night schedule, which still isn't as bad as what it used to be. I mean, we used to do Friday, Saturday, Sunday live events.
No, come on!
Tuesday. So we were only getting a day and a half because we flew out. And this was before
Friday.
So he would fly out Wednesday morning, get home. So you have half of Wednesday. You get home and you're beat. You're tired. You got half of that Wednesday. Then you have your Thursday to try to just handle personal life and family and everything that comes with that. And then you're back out on Friday. So for me, it was really just trying to balance everything. And someone who has 5 children, we're a very critical portion of
still the champion! So yeah, still champion!
And they get to know who their dad is. So for me, that's